But it also indicates that those that didn't hear this call, Thomas Jefferson made the statement that essentially there had to be a division. Mm-hmm. That if we remained here, that there would be a race war. Mm-hmm. And that it would lead to this termination of either one race or another. And this is the statement he made. And everything he's been saying up until this time has came true. He talked about the convulsions, how there would be an issue where blacks would, you know, would rise, and then they would be pushed down again, and there would be a constant struggle here, you know, he called it convulsion, the issue of racism because of the differences between us. Mm-hmm. So essentially what this scripture goes off into saying is that those that heed the call, mm-hmm, and take the reparations and leave would essentially be blessed. But those that remain would essentially somehow become a part of this conflict that Thomas Jefferson predicted, mm-hmm, and they would lose. So I think this is a perfect time, my brothers, to indicate the fact that it it would be wise for us to understand the history of our people, mm-hmm, and how we have continuously been struggling here in America. And majority of us love America like I do. I do love America. And the fact is, because I've traveled throughout the world, I've been in the Middle East, I've been in Africa, I've seen the struggles that our brothers are going through there. But I also realize that with our help, and with the technology that we could bring, and with the skills that we could have, that we could bring Africa into this new century or this new millennium. We can bring them into this. But essentially, but if we try to remain here, continuously struggling for the same, over the same old issues that our forefathers have struggled over 100 years ago, and now realizing that the Bible itself indicates that if we would leave and remember the homeland, but those that forget Zion, that they will be left for the slaughter. Oh, so this is, so please, my brothers, read these scriptures, jot these scriptures down, because what's been happening to our people up until this time has been prophetic. There's been nobody upon the face of the earth, according to the Bible, in Leviticus, the 26th chapter we quoted earlier, that have been under the persecution, that have been shipped to the four corners of the earth, that have been taken and sold, and their children have been ripped from them and sold, and they have been constantly downtrodden, and their redemption would only start when they ask God to forgive them for their sins, which is dominion and march.
I also want to make another point out of Isaiah in the 60th chapter. I want to start at verse number 9. Mm. Surely the owls shall wait for me, and the ships of Tarshish first, to bring thy sons from far, their silver and their gold with them, unto the name of the Lord thy God, unto the Holy One of Israel, because he has glorified thee. And the sons of strangers shall build up thy walls, and thy kings shall minister unto thee. For in my wrath I smote thee, but in my favor have I had mercy on thee. So here again, once we see, according to the scripture, we have read at least 3 to 4 scriptures up to this point, that clearly indicates that we're going to leave here with silver and with gold. And that equates to reparation. How people want to break that down and disseminate it, that's up to them. But I really appreciate the fact that the Most High have given us an understanding to go out throughout these scriptures to be able to know that he has a plan for us, and that plan is for us not to leave here with nothing.
That's beautiful, brother. You know, the fact is that the Bible, again, is showing over and over again, because a lot of brothers are saying, well, I just don't want no money. I don't want no dollar. We are essentially, our proposal for reparations has essentially been asking for, and this is the Israelite Organization of Unity proposal for reparations. Mm-hmm. And that proposal has essentially been asking for $1 million a person. Mm-hmm. We're asking for every individual, along with Thomas Jefferson's bill to be signed into law, we asking for every individual that would take up the flight to leave America to be given $1 million in gold, mm-hmm, in order that they could leave this country. And that $1 million, again, is nothing compared to all of the money, I'm saying again, that's going to the enemy right now in food. In food. So the fact is that now if you give the brothers this money, and anybody, and let me make this statement too, and anybody else of whatever race, of whatever denomination, of whatever background that want to leave with us, because again the Bible says that there will be a mixed multitude that will leave out, and that everybody that adhere to these scriptures and believe and want to come to the Holy Land with us in fulfilling God's prophecy, and according to this proposal that we have put forth, and is a part of the H.R. 40 to be studied, come with us, brothers, and let's fulfill God's prophecy, and let's bring in the real new world order with Jesus Christ.
There's another scripture that I like to try to bring in here if we have time to do so. Exodus in the 12th chapter, and I'm going to start at verse number 35, and it reads, "And the children of Israel did according to the word of Moses, and they borrowed of the Egyptians jewels of silver and jewels of gold and remnant. And the Lord gave the people favor in the sight of the Egyptians, so that they lent unto them such as things as they required, as they spoiled the Egyptians." One of the reasons I want to read that is that once God bring you into favor, because it appears that a lot of people is under the impression that this reparation is simply just not going to happen. That it's impossible, it's just undoable. This seems to be the mindset of a great deal of people here in America. But here we see that once God bring you into favor, it's possible and it can happen. And we have the faith and we have the understanding that according to scripture is going to happen, and we're just going to lean on that understanding, and we're going to hold on to that faith until it becomes a prophecy and become a reality. And this is the position that we're taking on this.
Hallelujah. I want myself to read one scripture here before we go, my brother.
Okay.
And it says, this is in Jeremiah 3 and 12. And let me read this very quickly. It says, "Go and proclaim these words toward the north, and say, Return, thou backsliding Israel, says the Lord. And I will not cause my anger to fall upon you, for I am merciful, says the Lord, and I will not keep anger forever. Only acknowledge thou iniquity, that thou hast transgressed against me, says the Lord thy God, and hast scattered thy way unto the strangers under every green tree, and ye have not obeyed the voice of the Lord thy God. Turn, O backsliding children, says the Lord, and I will take you one of a city, for I am married to you, and I will take you one of a city and two of a family, and I will bring you to Mount Zion."
Hallelujah.
So, my brothers and sisters, it's time for us to go home. And basically all we're asking is that let us go. Let us go without reparations. Thank you, my brother, for coming to the show today.
Shalom, my brother. Okay. Shalom.
Shalom. Repent for thy sins. Repent for thine objects. Repent, 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 repent. Repent for thine objects. Repent for thine sins. Repent for thine objects. Because we don't, we'll be at the end. Repent thy objects. Repent for thine sins. Because we don't, we'll be at the end. Just pick up a Bible and you'll know. Just read, 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 and you'll grow. Start in Genesis and read all through, and you'll see the things you should do. Here's how you repent. If you didn't know, you confess you're a sinner, then you'll grow. But you have to be true in your heart. Fast and pray, so you'll start to feel closer to the Lord is true. You take one step, he'll take two. Repent for thine objects. Repent for thine sins. Repent for thine objects. Repent, 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 repent. Repent for thine objects. Repent for thine sins. Repent for thine objects. Because you don't, we'll be at the end.